Hi, I'm Franco P from Home for Shooters. We're here at the long range shooting range of Rome. They have distances up to 500 yards. We're here to test the Pulsar XP50 Trail. This model, the LRF, it has a laser rangefinder, which is able to measure distances up to 1,000 meters and 1,000 yards, of course. The XP50 is the highest performing rifle scope from Pulsar with a thick 140 by 480 microbolometer. And let's see how it's made. And here is the Trail XP50 LRF. You see the laser range finding module is actually mounted on the left side of the rifle scope. The rifle scope itself has a capability of adjustment of about 6.8 meters on both elevation and windage. It has a Picatinny mount integrated in the structure, and we have mounted it on a Remington 700 police rifle in a 308. We're turning on the rifle scope. Once we have connected, once we have activated the Wi-Fi connection on the XP50, what we do is we start up the Stream Vision app, then we go in the settings tab, we connect to the Trail LRF network that is listed in the Wi-Fi networks that we see listed here, and we go back to the Stream Vision app. If everything works correctly, we should be the Trail LRF listed as the connected devices, and to check that that is the truth, we just push on the viewfinder tab. Now we are seeing what the device is actually seeing, and basically we have the confirmation that everything is working correctly. We're doing the one shot zero. We've shot our first shot. We have seen where it went on the target.
Perfect.
Now that we've zeroed the XP50, what we're going to use is the laser rangefinder to shoot at different distances. We've placed a target at 200 meters range, and what we're going to do, we're going to shoot the target and see what kind of drop we got. What we've seen is that our bullet struck low, about 11 centimeters. So what we're gonna do now is we're going to use the ballistics function of the app to see and confirm the drop of the bullet. We're gonna use the same ammunition we used for the zeroing, and we're gonna calculate. Now what we got here is 100 meters. We can directly place 200 meters here. We can also use the slider. We can use the angle, wind speed, and other functions, but what we need to know now is exactly how much the drop has been calculated. Now we've got here a 1.89 minute of angle, but we can use centimeters, so we have a direct of a value, and that is exactly 11.01 centimeters. So we're going to divide that into the numbers of clicks that we need to input, and then we're going to see on the target what we have.
Perfect.